Amen. I pray that all of us have gotten to a praise point.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
I'm reminded that God is better than our minds than ever imagined. Amen. 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 When you think about what He's done for you, and think about that, you didn't even think about it yourself. Think about how He protected you when everything was all around you. Think like I was gonna get sick, and yet I didn't get sick. I felt good. Amen. But he jumped in there before the symptoms developed in the inside. It seemed like that somebody was. I just felt something, and I felt like somebody was gonna do something bad to me. But it seemed like through the night, the Lord protected me. He covered me. Amen. Even in my drive, He protected me. Amen. He protected me. And I'm talking about He protected me. It seems like somebody was going to hit me on the road, but yet He protected me. He protected me. Amen. Even in the storm, He protected me. Amen. When I felt like I wasn't going to get up, He protected me.
Just thank God for being God.
Amen. Acts 16. Acts chapter 16. Amen. The time changed up. The rain came. Amen. I don't never have a problem getting up, but it was a hard godly moment. It was a struggling moment. Amen. It was a struggle for me to get up this morning. My head still hurt. Amen. Amen. But God. Amen. But God. Amen. The ninth verse of that 16th chapter reads, "And a vision appeared to Paul in the night. There stood a man of Macedonia, and prayed him, saying, Come over into Macedonia and help us." Amen. If you look at the latter part of that verse, "Come over into Macedonia and help us." Amen. Amen. I want to talk about this morning attractive versus attachment. Attractive versus attached. Amen. Amen. Attraction versus attached. I've been changing it 3 times. Thank you, Saint. And I'm reading off the paper I got it wrong. Amen. 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 On last Sunday, we were in the same chapter. And the Lord said something to me as we got in. I've been praying about a message for today. And I've been praying for messages, period. And I would be job of over for some make some new venue after we leave here. Temple's over there. The men's ministry that Cynthia mentioned, they're having a men's program here. They're using the building. I would like the men to come back and share with Pastor Jackson an abundant grace, because we're going to be calling on them to come and share with us. So since they're at our house, I think that you don't ever let somebody come to your house and pop their feet up and be not there. Amen. That made good sense to me. Amen. 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 So I've been praying that God will give me a word. And I said this on Wednesday, on Tuesday night, that God is changing some stuff in me. And I pray that you will understand that when God starts changing stuff in pastors, that it's not to benefit so much him as a person, but it's always to represent the ministry, the kingdom that God has set. And we have to follow leadership to a capacity to where we want to do what's being done. And I think a lot of people get mixed up when it comes down to follow leadership, because people on the outside looking in always say, "You just follow the man, you just follow." No. I think that when people understand ministry and understand God, understand kingdom, no matter how much people talk about their pastor, the only thing they're impressed with is the fact that he got a word from God.
Yes, sir.
Amen. It's not so much that he has something so special that nobody has had, but he has a word for the Lord for my soul.
Yes, sir.
Amen. And the Bible says that I send you pastors according to my heart and feed you with knowledge and understanding. Mama used to tell us, don't eat at everybody's house.
Yes,
amen. You can't eat at everybody's house. Amen. I used to come home a minute day hungry, because I used to hear mama's voice. You know, when you go to somebody's house, they say, you want that to eat? No, ma'am. No, ma'am. No, ma'am. Can't eat that, man. You can't. Amen. And mama will let you eat that. So God is sharing in where we are, because when the man showed up to Paul in a vision, they needed some help. They needed some help. They needed some help building what God had already implanted and put it in them They needed some leadership. They needed some guidance. They needed something different than what they were gaining. Amen. And there are a lot of hungry folk that's trying to gain without help to live it.
Amen.
Used to be years ago, and y'all bear with me just for a few minutes, I'm not going to be long. But just a few years ago, when I was a boy, just a few years ago, amen, they used to say the Bible that if a baby was skinny, he was malnutrition, and he wasn't healthy. Amen. So they would feed him a whole lot. They just feed him. Most babies didn't stay on baby food too long. They didn't stay on breast milk too long. They would start feeding them from the table. The baby would be on the floor, and mama would mash the greens and cornbread up with her finger. And she would pinch off a little bit and put some in the baby's mouth because they wanted the baby to be nourished and everything. So they would mash that food up off the table. They call it table food. And they would put it in the baby's mouth. And if the baby got fat, it doesn't help the baby. But in this season we're in right now, it's not healthy.
Amen.
It's not healthy. It's not healthy. It's not good sense. Amen. For somebody to gain, just to believe that I got something in me, I got to look like I got. See, what God is doing here, God says that if I can put something healthy in you, you don't have to look like you don't have to look like you're eating a lot. But see, when it comes out of your mouth, you ought to know that something. See, there was something about those men walking with Jesus on that road, and he said, "Did your heart burn?" Why the man of God spoke to our spirit. See, a lot of times we get stuff in us, and it's not. Attached to you.
Yeah.
So when they said we need some help over here, I thought about
about when God chatted with me last week, that we need some help over there, man. But I don't need help from folk that's attractive. I don't need some attack folk. I need some folk that can help us say that the business that we're for. I need some folk that's going to put everything you got in it. I need some folk that's going to 150%. I don't need 50%. I don't need 99.5%. I need 150% folk that's attached to the business that God has set before us. Because if you're not all in, you will quickly get out. Detours us when we're not all in. Anything happens, we slide. I used to tell folk all the time, if you got a husband, wife, boyfriend, significant other, you should never, ever, 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 did I say ever or no? You should never, ever listen to somebody else talk about me. Somebody bad mouth the person you with. You're not attached. Oh, y'all need to understand it. You're not attached to the person.
I believe.
reason I believe this. I want everybody on at Omega to prosper.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I want everybody that's attached to Omega to prosper.
Yes, sir.
I'm talking about prosper. I want you to have new cars, new houses. I want you to have nice jobs. I need your children nice. I need your clothes nice. I need you to look like kingdom.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Now, let me tell y'all this. I said this the other night. I said this the other night. I said this the other night. It's too many saints not trusting God. We don't have faith in God when it comes down to it. So one thing that we don't have trust in is our finances.
Amen.
We don't trust our God in our finances.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Everybody want to pay a bill off. Everybody want to have good credit. Amen. 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 And so what we do, we pay the bills off. We never save no money.
Amen.
We never give no money to God in a healthy way.
Amen.
Amen. And somebody said that, well, you know, we can't afford to save none now. We don't got all this stuff going on. Well, I told you I don't have a smart mind to think fast.
Right.
And I was thinking now. I bank with Bancorp South. Amen. I used to bank with Wells Fargo. I bank with Trustmark. I bank with Credit Union. Amen. I bank with. But before there was a First National, before there was a deposit guarantee, before there was a Regent, before there was a Wells Fargo and a Credit Union, before there was a bank in the country now. In the country or even in the city, before we had all of that, Grandma had a Folgers can. Grandma had a can. I mean, even if it wasn't Folgers. Not 12 ounce Folgers. Amen. She had a handkerchief. She was wrapped up. She untied the handkerchief. And she the only one you had untied. But she got to tie her hand and put that money off in there, and she looking to see if anybody watching her. She knew how to save money before First National ever had a money. What God is saying, if you don't really trust me and you're attached to me, if you will let me direct you in the spirit world with your finances.
Amen. They can put bad credit for your student loan.
They can't take your salvation. If you allow God to direct you where you are, God said there's never been a time that a man dropped a seed in the ground and it died and he didn't give harvest. When you're attached to what God really desires in you, everything you touch, God let prosper.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Amen. Everything he touched, he told Joshua, he said, wherever your feet tread, he said, I'm going to bless you with it.
Amen.
Amen. I used to be in a time to where I didn't trust him either. That's what I'm telling you. But when God allowed me to start trusting what he said, I don't believe it's nothing that I can't put my hand on. God is giving us in a place to where I'm designing and carrying you, because what I need you to do, I need you to stop being attracted to it. I need you to be attached to it. So one thing God said to me the other day, and I feel like I'm not finished. One thing he said to me the other day, we got to get desperate.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
We got to get desperate. Now, most desperate people, they beg.
Yes, sir.
We don't like begging. But when you get desperate, pride leaves you. Come on, don't go over there asking. They might think of us. Look, when you get desperate, I don't care what they think. I need this done, and I need it done now. When you get desperate, you don't have such a pride and such an arrogance on you that you won't tell people I'm in trouble.
Amen.
The man appeared to Paul and said, come over here and help us.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
When you get desperate, you want somebody to come over and give you some relief in where you are. This is what he said in Luke 6:38. He said, give good measure, press down, run it over, shake it together, press down. And then he said, men said, give it to your bosom. I get desperate enough to ask God to give me some help. God allows me to drop everything I'm doing, everything I'm holding on to, everything that I have, every problem I have. God said, drop it in the ground. And he said, what I'm going to do, I'm going to bless your life. We come up with schemes and schisms. You're trying to manipulate God into doing what we don't want to do. When you get attached, you understand that the only pride I have is in the God that I serve. God says, I want to pour out one in heaven. Open up one in heaven and pour you out a blessing that you can't receive. That's what he said. But if I get to a point that everything I do, I'm trying to manipulate in my mind, I'm going to just do this for a few minutes, y'all. And after I get what I'm going to get, I'm going to do something else.
Okay.
You're not attached.
Amen.
Amen. So God says, I need you to be desperate in where you are. And then he said, not only do I want you to be desperate, I want you to be serious about your desperation.
All right now.
And I don't need you to see, a lot of preachers used to preach out of desperation instead of inspiration. Amen. Because they needed some money. They wanted somebody to call them to preach. And they knew they could give $20 or $30. They could give some money to preach. But when you're desperate, when you're inspired by God, what God does is give you a word. And in that word that you give, he said, I'll let you give the word if you give it in season, out of season. He said, I'll bless you in times when it get hard for you. You'll never see the downfall of your. Because what God is doing now, he's preparing us for the next stage of ministry. I say all the time, we're going to the next level. Somebody asked me, when are we going to get to the next level? When your mind changes. When your mind changes. Amen. What about, now, let me tell you,
It's crazy, but I usually send Regina a text on something I want y'all to know. I send Regina a text, and she'll text everybody that she got in her phone. Y'all get a text from Regina? Bless God, I know your phone works. Last night about 10 o'clock, I started to text Regina and tell her to text everybody to make sure to push your clock up 1 hour. Well, I didn't do it. This morning I said, now, if people are serious about God, if people are real serious about God, why should I have to put the bottle in your mouth every Sunday morning for you? Because if y'all ain't go to work, y'all call somebody last night, it's a little girl or man, can you call me and wake me up in the morning? Because I know I'm old, sweet, and I need to get it. We're going to have to, amen, come on, finish now. We're going to have to get serious about what God is doing. We cannot allow the devil to get us in a position to where we lose the connection we are with God. Amen. It's too many people are not connected to God. We give God praise with one hand. We give God praise with one hand. Do y'all realize if y'all give God praise with both your hands? You know if you put a plug in the wall, it got two prongs on it. And when you plug it in, if you got just one prong on that plug, the left is not going to come on. But if you put both prongs in it, y'all need to understand it now. If you put both prongs in there, it's going to work. Because why? I'm not connected. I'm attached. I've done what I need to do. And I'm going to be able to light up. I'm going to be able to do what I need to do, God. Because I'm not just attracted. I'm attached. And the song says, everything attached to me wins. Everything. I'm telling y'all, when God is taking us now, there's a lot of people not going to understand your walk. They're not going to understand how you're going to do what you need to do. Y'all know how many folk get mad at me every week on the way I talk. They don't understand how this guy got to be a fool. Mario, y'all know Mario. Mario told me, he said, man, when you be talking, he said, most folks don't understand that they be going over the head. I said, can't be going over the head and telling that God is angry. How did they go on somebody's head and say, if you don't bless God, God will bless you? If they go up on somebody's head, how do you believe if you pray and see God is going to give something up? How did they go up on somebody's head? How do you understand that if I trust God, I got faith in God? How do you think that God is not going to do what he said? But man, reality is living. If I trust God, all I got to do is trust him. If I trust him, he's going to do what I ask for. And grandmother, granddaddy taught me this way, and you know I just didn't learn it that way. You know we had to do it this way. We didn't come up that way. We didn't have to pray all night. But let me tell you something. When the Spirit of God will hit you, and God will put you in another place, God directs you in an area that you've never been in. In Corinthians, God said to Paul when he took him into the third heaven, he said, I've shown you some things. You can't tell everybody this. They're not going to understand where you are. There's some stuff that God is doing with you all. Y'all ain't crazy. It ain't crazy to think that. When you start understanding that I can get anything I desire, and you start telling folk that don't understand that, stop letting them talk you out of it. If God said, if he said, it sounds crazy, but if he said, I believe what he said.
Yes, sir.
I believe that. I don't want to just be attracted to what God is doing in the atmosphere. I want to be a part of it. I want to be a part of the kingdom. I want to be a part of everything that God sent to me. Over in Luke 15, I think it was Luke 15 when the prodigal son went off. The Bible says he went off, he got all his money, he went off, and he had all his wives living, he did all that he thought he could do. Y'all remember as kids how mama kept you secluded in the house, she wouldn't let you do nothing, and she wouldn't let you do this, she wouldn't let you get certain friends you couldn't be around, and once you thought you got grown, you started smelling yourself. You just went out there and did your thing, and this is what that boy did. He did his thing. Oh, but the Bible says you come to yourself. He come to father, he come to himself. But it just hit my mind. He came to himself because he wasn't just attracted to Lord. He got desperate in where he was. He got desperate because the Bible says he was on a hog pen. And he desired to eat what the hogs would eat. Sometimes we get so low that we don't have no pride. We don't have But the Bible said because he was attached. In his mind, he saw his daddy. He said, my daddy got servants that live better than I'm living right now. My daddy got some stuff over there that I left this stuff to come to this place that I'm in right now. But because he was attached. And he got serious, he got desperate in his attachment. The Bible said he started back home. He started back home. When he got his letters, I think that's my boy coming. When he got to it, he said, Father, I have sinned against heaven, and I've sinned in your sight. He said, I'm not worthy to know your son any longer. He said, just make me one of your servants. But the Bible said, because he was attached. He wasn't attracted because he got desperate, y'all. He got desperate. The dad told the servant, he said, look, bring me a robe. He said, I can put on my son. He was gone. Now he's at home. He back where he needs to be. Bring me a robe so I can cover up all this mess. And don't you understand that once you get attacked, everything that you have done, every bad thing you've done, every hollow, dollar thing you've done, every dirty thing you've done, God said, I'm going to cover you up.
Your standard got to be different. You got to stop falling into stairs because everybody else is doing it.
with a blunt because everybody else. Simply because you don't have a standard of life. Amen. The Bible says, don't be tossed by every wind of doctrine. The devil will lead you to a point that he'll bring you just that right person around. That right person will come around just to mess you up. Just to mess you up. Yeah. It's been assigned to you to mess you up. Amen. In my closing, I think that every saint, every Christian, every believer, because you're attached, you're already structured with God.
Yes, sir.
If you ever talk to people that's got a platform, got a foundation, the structure is always shown. You already know. They're focused with God.
Yes, sir.
Amen. And so many people tell me all the time, they say, hey, you seem like you're that's focused on what you ain't gonna be. I ain't gonna be moved by stuff. I tell you what, I ain't doing that. Why? Because I'm not moved by what you're trying to do. If God didn't say it, if God didn't say it, have you ever had people try to rush you into something? And God didn't say it. Can you keep going? Come on here now. Can you keep that? I need you to come now. No.
God didn't say it.
Sam told me a phrase one time, and I adopted the phrase. He said, because we failed to plan, do not cause an emergency on somebody else's part. The devil always wants you to stop what you're doing. But since then, God didn't say it. And God didn't say it. See, my attachment, it gives me benefits. It gives me abilities because I'm attached. Amen. You can buy a car and they give you all this list of amenities that come with the car. Do you realize that because I'm attached to God, that's some amenities? Amen. Just come with the fact that God gave me. He just gave me some amenities. One thing you gave me a car, he gave me strength. He gave me power over the enemy. But it's because I'm attached to God. He gave me some structure. That's why I am. He gave me the ability to see stuff before it hit me.
Everybody in here, because you're attached to this ministry.
God showed me the walls are kicked out. People are in here. He showed me the people that fill these chairs. He showed me the ministry that are going to pour out of this ministry. But I need some strong people. I need some attached people that's not scared to say, for God I live.
You rested in us, God. You found us worthy.
found us worthy, God, to just to be called your sons. You found us worthy, God, because of who we are in you. Now, God, we want structure. We want to be structured in the attachment there, God. We want to be part of that three-strand cord. Oh, God, we want the anointing on our lives, God. And because the anointing is flowing in us, God, we realize that everything attached to us, it wins. We realize that everybody around us, favors on our lives, God. And everything we do, every place we go, God, we take charge, take over, oh, God, of just the room itself. Oh, God, we will walk in a place, oh, God, because the authority that's on us. Oh, God, you want to bring it, oh, God, to just that place. So, God, I bless you today. I bless you for every person. I bless you for every family, oh, God. I bless you not to doubt every mindset, God. I bless you not to the wrong thing that we are taught. Even today, God, our mind, our vocabulary will change, oh, God. Our purpose will change, God. And everything we do, Master, it'll be geared toward you, Master. I ask for God now in the name of Jesus that those things that I've been attached to,
God be the glory. I pray that we'll see you on Tuesday night. Amen.